Hello friends, I'm Vinay Mishra, well-known chemistry faculty among you. You are watching our channel Result Explorer. The previous topic we have discussed about the Faraday law of electrolysis. If you have missed this, then please click over the link given in the description below. And before we proceed further, I request you to subscribe our channel and click over the bell icon for future updates. About the defining of mole, it is amount of the substance which contains as many as particles or entities as present in 12 grams of C12 isotopes. 12 grams of C12 isotopes. So there are two things. This definition is related with the numbers as many as particles. Secondly, it is comparing with the 12 grams of carbon 12 isotopes. If it is talking about the isotopes, there are two carbon isotopes, that is carbon 12 and carbon 14. Why we have not considered as carbon 14? Because carbon 14 is radioactive in nature, and with the change in the time, the mass of the carbon 14 will get changed. So therefore, this mole concept definition comparing with the 12 C12 isotopes rather than C14 isotopes. Now, so therefore, as this mole is related to the number, Avogadro stated that this number is nothing but the Avogadro number, and that is equal to 6.023 or 10 to the power 23. And this Avogadro number can be denoted as N0, and in some book it is NA. So therefore, this one mole is related with the as many as particle as present in 12 gram C12 isotopes, which is equal to the 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. Particles present in any particle means when we are talking about the particle, it means atoms, ions or molecules. Now, how this moles is comparing with the atomic mass? Now, atomic mass is the average relative mass of the atoms of the element, which is again as compared to the 12 grams C12 isotopes. And as the carbon 12 grams of C12 isotopes is equal to 1 mole, so therefore 1 mole is also equal to the atomic mass of element. Now, for example, for example, we have atomic mass of sodium metal. Atomic mass of sodium is 23 grams. This 23 grams is equal to 1 mole. And this 23 grams of sodium metal will contain Avogadro numbers of particle, that is 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 atoms of sodium metal. We can take one more example. For example, we have helium, and atomic mass of helium is 4 grams. This 4 grams is equal to 1 mole, and this 1 mole carries 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 helium atoms. Now, when we comparing this 1 mole with the molecular mass, so this molecular mass, average relative mass of a molecules of a compound, which is again compared to the 12 gram C12 isotopes, that is called molecular mass of compound. And as the 12 gram C12 isotopes is equal to the 1 mole, so therefore 1 mole is also equal to the molecular mass of compound. So it means what we have, if we are taking an example for that, for example, we have carbon dioxide. Molecular mass of carbon dioxide that is 44 grams. This 44 grams will equal to the 1 mole. And this 1 mole will contain 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules of carbon dioxide. Similarly, we have one more example. Now, molecular mass of sulfuric acid, that is 98 grams. This 98 grams will equal to the 1 mole, and 1 mole contains 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules. Now one question arises, ki what is the mass of one atom or one molecules? This molecular mass 44 grams is of 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules. So one molecule will have. So we can have a formula for that. If we have to calculate mass of one atom, that is equal to atomic mass upon Avogadro number. Similarly, if we have to calculate the mass of one molecule, that is also equal to the molecular mass upon Avogadro number. It means the molecular mass, what we have, the molecular mass of the carbon dioxide, that is 44, that was the mass of 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules weight. So therefore, when we have to calculate the mass of only one molecule, that must be divided by the Avogadro number. That can give you the mass of one molecule, and similarly we can get the mass of one atom. Now similarly, we have Avogadro law. What the Avogadro law or Avogadro hypothesis states? Avogadro law state that at standard temperature and pressure, this pressure is 760 mmHg or 1 atm pressure or 1 bar, and temperature is 273. So again, what the Avogadro law state that at standard temperature and pressure, equal volume of any gas can contains the same number of particles. Again, it is comparing with the number of the particle, and Avogadro state that this number is nothing but the Avogadro number, which is equal to 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. So therefore, as the 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 is equal to 1 mole, so therefore 1 mole is also equal to 22.4 liter of any gas at STP. This volume is known as molar volume, and this is also equal to, that is 22400 ml or cc of any gas at standard temperature and pressure. And this volume is known as molar volume because this volume of any gas will equal to the molecular mass of that gas. This volume is called molar volume because this amount of gas of any element which exists in atomic form, that will equal to the atomic weight of that element. Now, for example, say we have carbon dioxide. Now, say we have a carbon dioxide. The volume of the carbon dioxide is given. The volume of carbon dioxide at standard temperature and pressure is given to you, and that is 22.4 liter. This 22.4 liter will equal to the 1 mole. Means this amount of the gas, carbon dioxide gas, at standard temperature and pressure will be equal to the 1 mole, and that must be equal to their molecular mass, that is 44 grams. So therefore, this 22.4 liter of carbon dioxide is standard temperature if it is a 1 mole, and that must be equal to the molecular mass. Now one thing is there, ki for example in 9th and 10th both we have stated that ki we always calculate the molecular mass by the sum of the atomic mass. For example, ki what this, how this atomic mass is related with the all these value. Say 1 mole of sulfuric acid there. So 1 mole of sulfuric acid means this contains 2 moles of hydrogen atom in gaseous state plus 1 mole of sulfur atom plus 4 moles of oxygen atom. So therefore that is also equal to 2 into Avogadro number of atomic particles are there, plus of hydrogen, plus 1 into Avogadro number of sulfur atom is there, plus it is 4 into Avogadro number of oxygen atom is there. That is also equal to 2 into 22.4 liters of hydrogen atom in gaseous state, plus 1 into 22.4 liters of sulfur atom in their gaseous state, plus it is 4 into 22.4 liters of oxygen atom in their gaseous state, and that is equal to 2 into atomic weight of hydrogen atom plus 1 into atomic weight of sulfur atom plus 4 into atomic weight of oxygen atom. Now so therefore we have 2 into 1 grams plus 32 grams plus 4 into 16 gram, and that can gives you 98 grams of sulfuric acid. So therefore how we can calculate the sulfuric acid 98 by the sum of the atomic weight, it is all related with the 1 mole. So therefore what we have, this is the gist of the mole concept, and 1 mole is related with the, all these things. One more formula is there. When we have a any amount of the substance is given, then how can we calculate the number of moles? Now third formula is there, the number of moles can be calculated as atomic weight. For if we are calculating for the atoms, it is atomic weight. It's not atomic weight. It is equal to the given weight upon atomic weight. If we are calculating for the molecules, then it is equal to the weight upon molecular weight. Molecular weight, to whom we are related, W upon molecular mass, or it is W upon molecular weight. So therefore the formula become, that is number of moles N is equal to W upon M. These three formulas are there for the number of moles, for calculating the number of moles and calculating the mass of one molecule or one atom. Now this is a small piece of demo. If you want to enjoy more chemistry in depth and want to attempt large number of problems, please visit our website www.resultexplorer.com, and which is a two-way interactive class where the student can ask the problem there simultaneously and at the spot where the topic is going on. Well, this demo is one-way interactive classes. Thank you so much. Visit our channel regularly. Thank you.